I reckon you didn't do it then.
Does it really matter?
Nah, not much. You know, I've driven a bunch of fellas down to this prison. Lord knows how many. Usually it's about now I get the, I didn't do it.
Not for me.
Because guys in your position already said it enough. Followed your case a little bit, you being a making boy and all.
What do you think?
I'm just glad I chose law and not order. Big messy trial like that. Even if you was innocent, a lot of what happened can't ever be undone.
Any of that seem important to you?
All of it, but that box never shuts up. Sit in this seat and pay too much attention and you'll drive yourself crazy. I got a nephew up at UGA. You teach there long?
Going on my 6th year.
You meet your wife in Athens? You want to know how I see it?
Not really.
Well, too bad. It's my car. You might have the right to remain silent, but it don't mean I gotta be. Regardless, could be you just married the wrong woman. You'll have to learn to stop worrying about things you can't control. I'm driving this man once. He was the worst one. He wouldn't stop going on about how he didn't do it. He was an older fella, big soft eyes behind a pair of smart folk glasses. And he just wailing back there. Says it wasn't him. Crying and snotting all over right where you're sitting.
All officers are available for incoming 21.
Then before long, he starts kicking the back of the seat like a fussy baby on an airplane. And I tell him he's got to stop. But that's government property. And I'll be forced to zap him otherwise. So he stops, and having exhausted all his options, he starts crying out for his mama. Mama, it's all a big mistake. It wasn't me.
Man.
Man? Not even close. They caught the fucker red-handed, stabbing his wife, cutting her up as the boys came through the door. He sits in my car screaming bloody murder that it wasn't him. I think he actually believed it himself. It goes to show, people will up and go mad when they believe their life is over. I got another good one for you. This one's a little bit less depressing and a bit more hilarious, if I do say so.
Fucking
this
try!
Other time...
gun out.
Hey, officer, are you all right? I'm still cuffed back here. Officer?
That doesn't look good. He wasn't ejected from the car. I need to drag myself out that window. Officer? His skin's all rotten and he smells like shit. What the hell is this?
Help! Go get someone! There's been a shooting! Anybody up there? Hello? Anybody in there? coming in. Don't shoot, okay? Not an intruder, or one of them. These people might need more help than I do.
Ed had a little incident with some crazy guy near the hotel, so we had to get him back to the ER and have it checked out. Anyway, he's not feeling well enough to drive back tonight, so we're staying an extra day. Thanks so much for looking after Clementine, and I promise we'll be back in time before your spring break.
Message 2. Left at 11:19 p.m.
Oh my God, finally. I don't know if you tried to reach us. All the calls are getting dropped. They're not letting us leave and aren't telling us anything about Atlanta. Please, please, just leave the city and take Clementine with you back to Murrieta. I've got to get back to the hospital. Please let me know that you're safe.
Message 3. Left at 6:51 a.m.
Clementine, baby. If you can hear this, call the police. That's 911. We love you.
Hello?
You need to be quiet.
Are you okay?
I'm okay. They tried to get me, but I'm hiding until my parents come home.
What's your name?
I'm Clementine. This is my house.
Hi, Clementine. I'm Lee. How old are you?
8.
And you're all alone?
Yes. I don't know where anybody is. How old are you?
I'm, 37.
Okay.
Where are your parents?
They took a trip and left me with Sandra. They're in Savannah, I think, where the boats are.
Are you safe?
I'm outside in my treehouse. They can't get in.
That's smart.
See? Can you see me? I can see you through the window. Did you kill it?
Yes.
It's okay. I think she was a monster.
I think so, too. You've been all by yourself through this?
Yeah. I want my parents to come home now.
I think that might be a little while, you know?
Oh.
Look, I don't know what happened, but I'll look after you until then.
What should we do now?
We need to find help before it gets dark.
Yeah, it's not safe at night.
Let's go. Stay close to me.
I ain't never getting home to Mama at this rate.
This sucks.
Oh, it's hot dish night.
What's the matter?
Should I stay?
What?
I don't want to sleep in the treehouse tonight, but I don't know if I should leave. What if my parents come home?
I won't leave you alone.
Well, let's go somewhere safe that's close, okay?
That's a good idea.
Hey, man!
Holy shit!
Don't eat us!
We're not gonna hurt you.
Yeah. Thought for a second you and the little one were both gonna give us the chomp.
Do you know what the hell this is?
No idea. So you've seen them then.
You could say that.
I'm Sean. Sean Green.
Lee, this is Clementine.
I'm Chet.
We shouldn't be out in the open like this. How about you help us clear the way, and we'll take you and your daughter out of here and down to my family's farm. It should be safer there.
I'm not a dad. I'm just some guy.
Some guy?
Yeah.
She's alone? Let's get going. Staying put for too long is a mistake.
What do you want to do?
I...
Your monster's coming.
We gotta go.
Lee, quick. Let's go.
Just some guy? Seems like you saved a bunch of lives today.
Hey, Sean, I'm gonna run on home. My mama's gonna be in a snit.
No sweat, man. I'll catch you tomorrow night.
It was nice to meet you both. okay.
I was worried it'd be bad here, too.
Been quiet as usual the past couple days.